Hey guys, in this video I want to go over how to do rejection sampling, which is also known as the accept-reject method or accept-reject algorithm. So this is one type of Monte Carlo random sampling method, and for this video I want to first introduce the algorithm and the concept behind it and then do an example in R and by hand afterwards. So let's go ahead and get started. So the idea or the motivation behind rejection sampling is you have some target distribution pi of x, and this is some distribution that you want to get random samples from, but it's going to be difficult to sample from pi of x directly. So maybe it's a complex function, and I'm going to just draw some random PDF, and let's call that our target distribution pi of x, and we want to be able to sample from this target distribution. The way the rejection sampling method works is, instead of sampling directly from pi of x, we're going to sample from some easy to sample from distribution. So some well-defined or well-known distribution, like the normal distribution, the uniform distribution, or some distribution that's easy to sample from. Then the rejection sampling method says, as long as there's some g of x distribution, proposal distribution, that's easy to sample from, that can be multiplied by a constant c, if c times g of x is always greater than or equal to the target pi of x, then you can use a random sample from c times g of x to get a random sample from pi of x. And I'll go over how the exact algorithm works in a second, but basically the idea behind this is going to be that you kind of want to create an envelope over your target distribution pi of x. So to describe how this rejection sampling method works visually, let's say this is our PDF pi of x. You basically want your proposal distribution times a constant to envelop your target distribution. By that I mean, let's say our proposal distribution is the uniform distribution. So the uniform distribution, when you graph it as a PDF, is just a straight line. Then if you do this straight line, whatever uniform distribution this is, times the constant c, let's say we multiply this by a positive constant c, so this is c times g of x, then for all points on the support of x, of the pi of x distribution, the c times g of x distribution envelops the target distribution. And the reason you want this envelope to be created for all the support of x is that then we're going to sample, and we're either going to accept or reject the new samples according to where they lie in this envelope. So if they lie under the target distribution and under c times the proposal distribution, then we're going to accept the samples. If they lie above the target distribution but below the proposal distribution, we're going to reject those samples. So by doing that, we have samples that we can easily sample from, and then we're just going to accept a subset of those samples, and then the subset of those samples will be distributed according to our target distribution. So formally, the algorithm is, we're going to draw samples from our easy to sample from distribution, g of x. Then we're going to draw random samples from the uniform 0, 1 distribution. Then we're going to accept each random sample x of I according to the following formula. We're going to accept x of I if u of I, which is each random sample from the uniform distribution, is less than or equal to pi of x of I divided by c times g of x of I, and we're going to check this for all I, otherwise we reject. So from our sample of x, we're going to accept some of these x of i's and reject some of them, depending on whether or not they fall under the target distribution, and we can check that using this formula. Then our accepted random sample of x of i's will follow the target distribution pi of x that we were looking for in the first place. So that's the algorithm and the concept behind the algorithm. So now let me go ahead and do an example. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and go over this example. It says to design a rejection sampling algorithm for generating random samples from this target distribution pi of x. And when we look at pi of x, it's a distribution that's difficult to sample from directly. It's basically a third degree polynomial with support from 0 to 1. And so this is not a well-known distribution, and it would be difficult to get a random sample from here directly. So we're going to use the rejection sampling method to sample from this distribution. I went ahead and I plotted in R the PDF of our target distribution pi of x. So this is pi of x on the support from 0 to 1. So this is the PDF that we want to randomly sample from. So let's go over how we would do one way of doing the rejection sampling algorithm for this target distribution. This distribution is continuous with finite support from 0 to 1. So this PDF only has to exist on the support from 0 to 1, and it's a continuous distribution. So this has a special case where the g of x, our proposal distribution, can always come from the uniform distribution. So when you're doing rejection sampling and you want to know what should I use as the proposal distribution, there's never one right answer. It could be whatever comes to mind first or whatever works for you. But when you have a continuous distribution over finite support, the uniform distribution can always be your proposal distribution. So if we think of the uniform distribution, as we said before, if we plot that as a PDF, it just looks like a straight line. So since this support is from 0 to 1, a uniform 0 to 1 distribution would just look like this. This is uniform 0 to 1. The PDF would be the value 1 at y is equal to 1 from 0 to 1, and it would just be a straight line. We have that, and that works over our support from 0 to 1. But now we need to make sure to multiply our proposal distribution, the uniform 0 to 1 random variable, by a constant c to make sure that our proposal distribution envelops the target distribution. So in other words, our target distribution has to be at least up to here so that all the values that we sample from, we can make sure are beneath our target distribution. So if I look at what is the value of the target distribution at the end of the support, which is at x is equal to 1, in other words, if I plug in 1 to the PDF, that will give me a value of 3.125. And since this is basically a monotonically increasing function, basically we see that the highest value or the largest value of pi of x will only ever be 3.125. So if this is 1, and I want to make sure that I get at least the highest value of the target distribution pi of x, then we can say, or we know, that the constant that we should multiply our proposal distribution by should be 3.125. Or you can think of it as it should be at least as big as 3.125. You can make it bigger, but that will just mean you end up rejecting more samples. So if you want the tightest uniform distribution that will have you reject the fewest number of samples, it should be 3.125. And that's also the easiest value to come up with. So now we have our proposal distribution, or sometimes it's called the instrumental distribution, which can be g of x is uniform 0, 1. And we know that if we multiply that by c, which is 3.125, then we will always be under the target distribution, and we can do rejection sampling. So if I wrote that out in words instead of trying to do it visually, I can say we're going to draw random samples x from the proposal or instrumental distribution uniform 0, 1. Then we're going to draw uniformly random samples from uniform 0, 1 again. And then we're going to accept x of I if the uniform random samples are less than or equal to pi x of I divided by 3.125 times g of x of I, and otherwise we'll reject. Then we expect our accepted x random samples will be distributed according to the target pi of x. Okay, so that's our algorithm for this example. So now let's go ahead and do this in R. So I switched over to R, and I'm going to go over this short R demo. So I'll try to put the code for everything in the description box below, but it's a pretty simple algorithm, and it's pretty simple to code it yourself. So the first thing I did was just include the code for how I printed out the PDF. Again, by hand, I usually do this with a graphing calculator, but this is how you would do it in R. You basically just pass through the function of your target distribution pi of x to the function called curve over the support 0 to 1, which is our support of x. And then I plotted the AB line, which is just a straight line, which would be our proposal distribution g of x times c. So our proposal distribution would be basically at y is equal to 1, it would be a straight line from 0 to 1. That's the uniform 0, 1 proposal distribution. And then if we multiply that by the constant 3.125, it will give us this line here. And that covers all the support of the target distribution pi of x. And the next part is the actual rejection sampling code or the rejection sampling algorithm. So I randomly sampled from our proposal distribution g of x, which is uniform 0, 1. So I'm calling those random samples x, and I took 4,500 random samples from the uniform distribution. We're going to reject some of those samples, so our accepted final random sample number will be smaller than 4,500, but I just picked that number to make sure it was more than 1,000. So in this example, I'm trying to at least get 1,000 random samples that are distributed according to our target distribution. The second step is we have to sample from the uniform 0,1. So in my example, just by chance, our proposal distribution was also uniformly distributed from 0 to 1, but that doesn't always have to be the case. In this case, it just happens to be the same. Then this line of code runs a function or saves a function as pi of x. So we're going to use this as part of our accept reject formula. So I need to have this function here. Then I set up a counter starting at 1, and accept is going to be an empty vector that I fill with the accepted random samples from x. So I'm going to run that. And then this is how I wrote the accept reject algorithm. Basically, I said that while we still have simple random samples, so while our sample that we've been cycling through is less than 4,500, and while we have fewer than 1,000 samples that are accepted, keep cycling through this loop. So basically, I keep cycling until you run out of samples or our sample size reaches 1,000, which is what we want. And then within the while loop, we basically want to make sure that we accept x of I if each u of I is less than or equal to pi of x of I over c times g of x of I. So our u of I is going to be test underscore u. And that's just going to be, we're going to pick one random sample from u. And then our x of I is going to be pi of x of I divided by 3.125, which is our c, times our g of x. So our g of x, again, is just from the uniform distribution. Then I have an if loop. So if the u of I is less than or equal to the test underscore x, which is our fraction, we're going to add it to our accepted vector. If it's not, we're just going to increase the counter. So if we accept it, we accept it, and we add it to our vector of accepted random samples, and then we increase the counter. Otherwise, we just increase the counter, meaning we reject the sample. So I'm going to run that. And the value of the counter will tell me how many values it took for me to get 1,000 random samples. So from 4,500 random samples that I thought I would need, I ended up only needing 4,188. And our accept vector now has 1,000 values. And I'm going to plot the histogram of the accepted vector, the vector of all the accepted random values, to show that it should look similar to the PDF. So if I run this last line of code, this will give me the histogram of the values in our accept vector, which we're saying is a random sample from the target distribution. And if I compare the histogram to the continuous PDF, we see that empirically it does look like it is coming from this PDF. So it looks like the values are correctly being sampled from our target distribution. So it looks like the rejection sampling method does work. And that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.